McNiven. Happy birthday, buddy.
The reason we're here is to celebrate Yvonne's 90 years of life, and I like to compare her life to a beautiful tapestry. I never made a tapestry, but I know there must be a lot of work that goes into it. I don't know how much it trails. And I'm sure that each of you who are here somehow fit into that tapestry of her life. Now, we're going to have the first number on the program. It's going to be by the line of Jocelyn Orr family. I think Rick is somewhere to get a mic to that, so that'll be the next on the program.
Hey there, everybody! It's Apple Orr! What do you know? Numbers, and we said, yep, you bet.
you're happy, babe, when you're laughing, well, the sun comes shining through. But when you're crying, you know you bring on the rain. Stop that sighing. Be happy again. Keep on smiling. 'Cause when you're smiling, and the whole world smiles with you. Always.
Thank you.
God to write down the name of that number of stairway to heaven. And we certainly do appreciate that. By the way, you know, I'm getting old, but is that Barney and Merle over here? I didn't know you were 80 years old. My sympathies, Bob. If you don't know what I'm talking about, ask somebody next to you. I'm trying not to embarrass anybody, but I already have. I want to tell you a little story about being a senior and some of those senior moments. My wife and I, not too many years ago, attended in Rexburg, Idaho, graduation of one of her grandchildren, high school graduation. Actually, it was not. It was a basketball game. I'm sorry. One of our granddaughters' basketball games. And on the way to the game, my daughter said, and they're going to be honoring the seniors tonight. And I thought, how do they even know we're seniors? We're from Canada. If you don't catch on to that, why, there's no hope for you. Because I didn't catch on. So the next grandchild, Cheryl Gunderson family, and I think they're going to do some kind of a song. Are they ready? Somebody said, yep. Not quite. Not quite ready.
You don't have to be sorry. He's totally fine.
How much time do you need back there?
You're good.
Oh, I'm good. Tell okay, I'm going to tell you a little story. This was told to me by Renee. I think it was yesterday. She tells the story, and I think she heard this, of course, straight from her mother. But apparently, Vaughn and Noreen Parker, probably Noreen Salts later in life, they were riding home together from something on both on the same horse called Peanut. Now this Peanuts was a very steady and sure horse, and they were making their way home, and they were in the middle of the road, and pretty soon a vehicle came out behind them, and with headlights on, and that made it a lot nicer for the ride, that you know, they could see where they were going, the horse could see where it was going, and so they rode along for quite a while, and finally they decided, well, maybe we should get out of the way. The car couldn't pass because there had been recent rains and ruts, and the vehicle was in the ruts. Couldn't pass, and pretty soon they did get out of the way. They said it was Uncle George. You know, it's probably George Harbinger, that's just my guess. But anyway, he was quite patient as he followed them for quite some time as they rode their horse. But anyway, all went well. Are you ready back here?
Yeah!
Woo!
We're ready.
That wasn't true. We'll straighten this out after this number. I'm telling you, untruths up here.
Grandma's, take me home, country road. gathered round her. Farmer's lady, card playing master. Only green ones left. Caramel popcorn, old westerns are the best. Country roads take me home to the place I belong. Belly River down to Grandma. Drive down to the school far away, running through the gauntlet, dodging eggs, just to prove to us that you can stay, you can stay. Country road, take me home to the place I belong. Past the horse plant, a cold there, shed a tear. Country road, take me home to the place I belong. Elm River down to Grandma's, take me home.
Oh, there's two hands at the back. Well, I'll be darned. How embarrassing. Well, apparently she still doesn't know about that. Thank goodness. But anyway, just another brief incident with Vaughn and David Coombs. For some reason, I don't know if Vaughn can remember, we were headed to Rosemary in the pickup truck. And, you know, pickup trucks back then weren't like they are now. You were lucky if you had heat in them. And we were partway to Rosemary, and we all thought we should have something to eat. Wasn't there anything in the truck to eat? And stuff was rattling under the seat. Vaughn said, "I think there's a bottle of olives in there." And she reached under the seat and pulled out a bottle of olives. They're still frozen. You know, we've gone probably for an hour or so, and they're still frozen in the truck. But I think that's where I learned to like olives. We sucked on frozen olives the rest of the trip. Do you remember that? I think she remembers that. Are the Rick and Renee family ready? Yep. Pardon?
Yep, right away.
Sooner or later. While I'm waiting, I see Rochelle down here.
You were a flower girl at
the wedding of my wife, and I do remember that. I don't remember that.
Well, it was probably your wife.
Probably my wife. How old were you? Do you have any recollection?
I was either 5 or 6.
Well, you got a good memory. I didn't have hair until I was 5, and I didn't have a memory until I was 10. You did well. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Bring him home.
So the next group we need to get ready is Dave and Noni's family. And while they're getting ready, I'll just tell you a little bit more about some of my association with Vaughn and her family. After being away on a mission, attending BYU and then getting married, I brought my wife home to the farm. She was a city girl, and she was so excited to come to the country where the well didn't work, and so we had to use an outhouse for a while and all that wonderful stuff. But she's adjusted now. I don't think she can leave the farm unless she had to. Anyway, I was raised in Orton, of course, by then Orton and McLeod had combined as one ward. But nevertheless, I was still related to pretty well all of the Orton people that were in that ward. And having been away for several years, and my wife being a new person in the ward, we kind of fell out of place. I don't know if you've ever had that experience. And bless their hearts, the Vaughn Orr, Alma and Vaughn Orr family, and the Keith and Marlene Orr family, so the word we like to use is they took us under their wing. And we spent many, many years doing things with those families. So is the next act ready?
Yep.
Okay, I don't know what... Oh, Ashley's going to introduce this number. I finally got something right. Does she need this mic?
Context. Hi, I'm Ashley. So a couple years ago, around March, 2 years ago exactly, something happened that gave me a lot of time at home. And I taught myself how to edit some videos. And so that summer, David and Nomi Orr had a little bit of a family reunion down at the river. And I had the thought, I should just take some footage and maybe edit something together for my family keepsake so we can see how fast these grandkids grow up. And then it turned into telling the whole story of the farm, which was very, it's like a 20-minute long video, and it was a little bit of a labor of love, and I'm grateful that I was able to sit down with my grandma before and kind of interview her and ask some questions just about the farm and how her and grandpa, how they got the farm, and just a little bit of their story. And it's a very humble, you know, I just had my phone and my little GoPro to make this video, but I'm super proud of growing up in Fort Macleod. I'm super proud of the life that I had. I have no regrets. I loved my childhood. Now, as I get older, I see the sacrifice, and I'm so grateful for the sacrifice of my grandma, my grandpa, my aunts and uncles, bringing us together as much as we did. I love my cousins a lot, and there's like instant best friends, you know, and so I just want to thank all of you for making that effort, and for everyone making the effort to be here today to celebrate your mom. I love you very much. And so this is just the first part of the video. My dad was watching it a couple weeks ago and thought that it would be nice just to show it, so I said sure. So it's just the first couple minutes of it, and
my name is Ashley Marie Orr Scow, the 24th grandchild of Alma and Yvonne Orr. I was raised on the windswept prairies of southern Alberta. To most, this land is insignificant, but to me, this is and always will be home.
So I am Yvonne Coombs Orr, and I married Al December the 14th, 1950, and we moved to a farm down on the Valley River, and we had 8 children. And now I have 34 grandchildren. And I haven't counted lately, but I think I'm just over 60 grades. When Al first came off his mission, we were in Salt Lake. I went to Salt Lake to meet him. He came home from California. He went right downtown Salt Lake and got released. And then we could have a hug and a kiss. But we dated off and on for 4 years. It took a little longer to catch him. I thought he wanted to be a pilot or a photographer, but he'd been farming actually with his dad and his brothers for a few years. Then he went on his mission, and when he came home, the Bishop of the Lord said, I know where there's a farm for sale down on the river, and I will help you put the down payment on it if you think you want to farm, if you think you want to live here. And so when Al came and saw it, he went, yeah, I would really like to have that farm. I think he actually really liked farming, liked horses, liked maybe not the actual hard work. I mean, you don't know how hard it really is until you get into it and trying to meet all the bills and keep the machinery running and raising a family. But he was happy here. He loved people, and he always welcomed anybody to come. And it was my style of life, too. I didn't mind making extra food or whatever, you know. The old fellow that Al befriended, the native fellow, he used to ride his old white horse. He couldn't talk English, but somehow him and Al understood each other. Mm-hmm. He would come over here and I would make him some food to take, and he'd go back across the river on his horse, and his name was Blue Wings. And they lived in a house just across the river east on the reserve. After him and old Blue Wings got to be good friends, Al and Blue Wings, then it was an honorary thing that they gave Al traditionally the name of Blue Wings to honor for Al to be given, passed on that traditional name. We had the best neighbors and the best, such good people all around us, you know. There was just so much contentment. It wasn't fancy. We didn't have big boats. We didn't have any of that stuff. But just even a few of us get together and go riding horses. Or I guess just the whole life, we were contented. You know, we had everything to make someone happy. It can be a tough life, hard work, but that's what I mean by tough. That you work on a farm. We'd go on holidays and then he'd be, I just want to go home. And he just loved to go down there, and so did I, because he could hear the river at night, you know. We'd just go down under that favorite tree and throw out some blankets and have a nice sleep. From Europe, and we'd been gone a month with your parents. He said, okay, I'm going down by our tree in the morning at 4:30 and I'm going to watch the sunrise. He said, I've seen enough people for a while. When you're in Europe and you go into London and some of these places, they're just people. Mm-hmm. He said, I've seen enough castles and people to last me for a while. I am so blessed to be able to still be here. And Renee is a saint. Rick helps a lot, too. Anyway, yeah, I'm very blessed to have the life.
Mm-hmm. I sure love you.
I sure love you, too.
That was great, Vaughn. Well, it happens. And yeah, we just live upstream a little ways from them. Been neighbors for pretty well all my life. We've had a lot of good memories with Vaughn and her family. Now the next thing we're going to be pleased to hear from is her nephew David Coombs. He's going to give a tribute to Vaughn. And following that, I will turn the mic back to David. So I'm almost done here. I can relax. But before I sit down, I've got to show off a little bit. I don't fall off the stage.
How do you like my socks?
Those socks were given to me by a nephew of Vaughn's. And I've got some more he gave me too, but when you... Pardon? Sorry, it was a grandson of yours. A grandson of yours gave me these socks. Did I say, I'm sorry, I apologize. Now, your parents were from England, and I remember your parents well. And did they ever use the saying spot on? Oh, yes. Well, I must have English socks because the spot on. I never could figure out what that was for, and now I know they're English socks. Is that right? I'm going to just show you very quickly, you've heard enough from me, a few of the things that. With the two Orr families during our lifetime, we would go skiing, we went to a trip to Vancouver, and Vaughn still hasn't forgiven me for that. What was it we didn't see? Was it Vancouver? No, it was that Chinatown place, wasn't it? No. And something we didn't see. She's never forgiven me. We went to Disneyland, I think maybe twice. Kalispell, probably skiing in the winter. I'll just tell you a little bit about that story. I think there was the six of us, or maybe there was eight of us. And just the adults there. And we had a motel room and rooms, but we were all in one room. And some of us had our pajamas on, some didn't. And I think it was Vaughn's brainy idea we should go downtown to get some snacks. And I said, well, I'm in my pajamas. Well, that doesn't matter. Just put your coat on. So several of us just put our coats on over our pajamas and shopping for drinks. Yeah, I don't know if people thought we were strange or what it was, but you know, we used to go down to the river that was shown so beautifully here and have potluck dinners a lot of times on a Sunday. Yeah, there was just so many good memories. Just one thing I want to mention, and then I'm going to turn the time over to David Coombs. My mother, bless her heart, had a wonderful family. Nuts. Four more. David Coombs, where are you? Finding a job I'm good at.
Dennis and I became friends at 12 years of age. And I've never got him to do anything for me now, but now he used to do it. So Vaughn comes from a family of nine children. Her father, Bertram, passed away at 91, and her mother, Hannah, died at 95. Irene was 83, Helder was 84, Francis was 5 months, Jack was 85, Francis, my father, was 25,
That was during the war.
Gordon was 40. Sylvia, who's here tonight, is 95. And Vaughn is 90. So that Vaughn has still got a few more years to go. Being the youngest in the family, we lived in Rosemary, and our little one-room house, what it was to begin with, was, I don't know, 100 yards from the house that she was raised in. And so we became pretty close. Christmas time wasn't Christmas without her. We go to Grandma Coombs' house and she was Santa Claus. She came to our house to me and my two sisters and she was Santa Claus. She meant a lot to us. She, I don't know, we're 11 years older than I am, so she was our babysitter a lot of the time. And she was close to our family. One of my cousins said, Gabe, you need to come on to your stories before you get into this treatment, you know. And so I'm going to kind of switch this around a bit. You know, as a teenager in Rosemary, she was actually the queen at an MIA dance. How many knew that? And the thing she wanted the most was new shoes for that dance. Correct? Did you get the shoes? Okay. And even as a young girl, she liked the old pickles. And the reason we know, because often we hear her mother say, Vaughn, get out of the pickles. Christmas dinner, quite often we had at my grandparents' place. And she could sit with the adults, but she always set the adult table and came to the kitchen and sat with us kids. Shows where her heart was. She actually milked some cows. And she had me down in the cows. And she'd make fun of me because how I would say the cows are too far away. And she told me to tell the story of the three bears quite often. And I always thought she liked the story of the three bears. And one night, the day afternoon, we were walking from school. We were about a block from the school. She was walking with a friend. And she said, Dave, tell me the story of the three bears. I told the story of the three bears and I started laughing. And I first realized, and I was about maybe 7 years old, they were laughing at me, the way I spoke, not at the story. Go ahead.
I probably didn't hear that, Dave. Can you do it?
Yeah, you know it. I would say, Dave, tell the story that you bear. He was so cute, his little bib over all his front, getting her there. Anyway, I'd say, tell me the story that you bear. And he'd go, I won't tell you all, but it was just like when the bears came home. And damn, the seal bells take hold. And he'd go, get the cows. I can't hold cows to saw a wheel.
Describe in one word their mother. Never had to move to two. Never had to move to three more than that. So some of the single words were tenacious, rictitious, caring, loving, kind, sensitive, brave, true, fun, worker, balanced. Adding a few more words, fun loving, classy and sassy, good hearted, never quit, always clean. Inviting place, quick-witted, tender-hearted, hard-working, great example, dad's sweetheart. And then, three or more. Full of energy and life, committed to being a mom her whole life. Sense of humor, very willing hope, keeps going every day, help with farm work, always put others first. Full of energy and life, doing fun things, good homemaker, devoted to God, family and friends, loves and accepts everyone, kept the ship rolling, great example of fun and work, has a green thumb. Remember that, right? She has a green thumb. Great gardener, great teacher on how to care for clothing and fabric. quote this now. So, in acting, I went on the internet to find out when you give a tribute, things are supposed to come, and after you talk about the person, which I've just done, then you also have to have evidence of her doing those things. I can testify of all those things, because I lived at that farm when I was 12 years old for 1 week. When I was 13 years old, 2 weeks. When I was 14 years old, 4 weeks. And after that, the whole summer until I was 19, went on my mission. So I spent 9 summers at the old farm. And I can testify through my experience, having been there and witnessed that she's done all of those things. And Vaughn, we love you, and everyone here tonight loves you. You've been a great example, and we appreciate the example you have set for all of us, and we all love you. It's funny because I shouldn't say this, but there was one thing she refused to do for me. You remember what that was? Al and I had castrated pigs, and I brought a bucket of pigs for you to cook the balls and eat them, and you would not cook them for us. So you love her anyway.
Hey Dave, before you go back to Edmonton, if I can get you a bucket of any kind of balls, I'll cook them for you. I have some tennis balls. We're going to be treated now with a number from, I think, the great-grandchildren. So if you can come up and get ready.
Are you going to?
How many great grandchildren do you have, Vaughn?
16.
17?
70.
70. Holy crow.
Yeah.
You're way up there.
I don't think you can
laugh. What a beautiful sight. Is it? Who beat the Gigi sign? Is that what you were known as? Gigi?
Yes,
yes.
Now, David, when they're finished,
I love you.
children, that was wonderful. And Yvonne, we all love you. We do. That pretty well takes care of the program thus far. In a moment or two, David Orr will be out here, and I don't know if he has anything more to say. Oh, you're coming back? Hey, wonderful. They're coming back, but they don't know what they're going to do, they say.
Kim.
No. So, Mom's posterity, come up on the stage. December 23rd, the day we go caroling, and it's also my birthday. And so I get a happy birthday sung to me by this group. So tonight, we're going to sing happy birthday to you, Mom. So as soon as we're ready, Jared, and we're all on stage, we'll give it a go. Now, we want to express our thanks to Dennis for his MC. Please give him a round of applause. And you can see Mom wants to say something, which is great. Yes, you want to say something, Mom? And we also want to thank our brother, David Coombs, for his words. So, Mom, you've got a few words. Let me bring that mic over to you.
She's got all sorts of stuff back. Family moves to Rosemary, where grass is up to the cow's belly.
so to say. I was 9 years old. Now that was a move sent from heaven. To grow up in, to spend my teenage years dancing, house parties, getting into trouble with Norm, riding old Keenan's Parker's horse, growing up with so many kind, caring people, not a lot of money, but neither did anyone else, but so much goodness. Al Orr from Orton comes to Rosemary to work for Uncle George. He was so dashing, so handsome. Well, all the girls, we went crazy. Smack, I would say. But who's going to get the first dance? Well, I was tall and I looked older for my age. Hey, he did. What? There's so many tears. He did say he had to himself that he'd have to wait for me to grow up. And there was a 2-year mission for him. But there was a lot of dancing before he left. How Al loved to dance. Great memories. Again, a godsend. Once again, Rosemary and all the great people. Well, at 18, I was all grown up. And we got married and made another godsend move to Orton. Our Bishop Arnold Champlin found this farm on the river. He helped us to get a down payment, and we went farming. Where am I? And our staff helped us get into the cattle business. We moved into that big old house, snow blowing through the cracks in the corners. Irish chickens up in the upstairs bedroom. Al loved their little feet running around over our heads. So many good neighbors. Tolley's over the hill. Dear God's up the hill. Cutterites over the fence. And the native people across the river, who we both came to love so much. And all the good people who took me in, loved me. We had plays, dancing in our little church. We had lots of work parties. So much fun. And again, not much money. I was again so blessed. We were especially blessed with 8 beautiful children. Children become some of our best heroes. And I honor them and thank them this night for all that they have done. I love you all and thank you for such an important part you have all played in my life. I have a bit of advice. It is, life is short. Smile while you still have
teeth. You say, where's Katie and Hannah?
They're on the stage. Hold on up. There is a certain song that I really love, and I want to dedicate it all to you. Katie and Hannah.
Thank you.
So this song is called No Man Is an Island, and I just heard this song, but it is Grandma's beloved song and a gift for all of you. So here it goes.
Woo! Thank you.
You're welcome.
No man is an island. No.
Let's skip it back.
Okay. No man is an island. No man stands alone. Each man's joy is joy to me. Each man's grief is my own. We need one another. So I will defend each man as my brother. I saw the people gather, I heard the music start, the song that they were singing is ringing in my heart. No man is an island, way out in the
When you're smiling, when you're smiling, the whole world, it smiles with you. When you're laughing, babe, when you're laughing, well, the sun comes shining through. But when you're crying, you know you bring on the rain. Stop that sighing, be happy again. Keep on smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. Oh, let's go. When you're crying, you bring on the rain. Stop that sighing, be happy again. Keep on smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
keep on smiling,
the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing,
keep on smiling now.
When you're laughing,
you'll get through somehow.
The sun comes shining through
when I'm with you.
But when you're crying, you know you bring on the rain. Stop that sighing, come on, be happy again. Keep smiling when you're smiling, baby. The whole world